time to begin the breakfast of champions. I think it's a three sandwich kind of day. The key to making an awesome peanut butter and jam sandwich is that you have to respect the fact that everyone has their own way of doing it, you know? Like, it's taken me years to discover exactly how I like my PBs and J's. And it's with, like, peanut butter on 3/4 of the bread, and then marmalade on 3/4 on the other side, coming back. And then you fold them in half and you feed the last piece of crust on each sandwich to champ. That's a very important step. You do not want to forget that step, because otherwise he will kick you and he will paw at you until you feed him crust. It's very important. That's the good stuff, man, right there. What is your go-to cereal?
My go-to quick breakfast in the morning is Lucky Charms. Because I'm an 8-year-old.
But you're in good company. It was Casey Neistat and John Green's favorite cereal.
That's true. We were watching vlogs and we found out that both Casey Neistat and John Green eat Lucky Charms, which made me feel a little bit better, especially because Casey's like super fit, which means that having Lucky Charms is the secret to fitness. That's they just it. Don't want you to know.
Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. Mm-hmm. At the Bristol International Speedway. So this speedway, I don't know that much about NASCAR. There's only one guy in my high school who kind of liked NASCAR, and that was about it. So, like, my experience to NASCAR isn't—I'm not what you'd call an expert. But this speedway is interesting because it's known as one of the loudest ones in all of the United States, and the reason for that is it's got really steep banks, and so when you racing it, you can get some pretty high speeds, even though it's actually called a short track. So it's not very big, but it's got really steep banks, surrounded by these hills, and it packs a lot of people inside of that tiny little stadium. Well, tiny, retrospectively speaking, compared to other American NASCAR stadiums, this is actually pretty small. I can't fathom, because this is gigantic compared to the stadiums we have at home. I was like, what the hell's that noise? There's Canadian geese right over there. They're like, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, go get the geese. We're just having a little bit of lunch here in that grass parking lot. I guess it's the overflow parking lot of the Speedway. Honestly, this wasn't a planned excursion to come out here and see the Speedway. We only stopped because we were tired of driving last night and wanted to work on some stuff online, and we needed this big enough city to get a decent Wi-Fi connection to upload everything. So Bristol it was, and we didn't know anything about it. Apparently it's also the birthplace of country music. Who knew? Anyway, where neither of us are particularly huge country music fans, and neither of us are particularly huge NASCAR fans, but we are big lunch fans, so we're having lunch, and then we're going to hit the road. So we have another 3.5 hours of driving today before we get to our campsite tonight. So I'm hoping to get there with some daylight to spare. So very few distractions on the driving today, unfortunately, but kick-ass campsite tonight, hopefully. So let's go. It's a lot of hill. Apparently our campsite's on the top of the mountain. This van engine's not liking that one too much, but we're almost at the top.
How are you doing, champ? You anxious?
The Ridge Parkway. I can see why.
How can you not just love this dog? You just look at him. Look at his little brown eyes. His little gray chin. Now we're going back down the hill. Smells like a campground?
Might be a campground.
Tastes like a campground? Think of this campsite, champ. It's gonna be your home for the night. Is that okay with you?
Champ, is everything okay with you always? Is it a camp?
What's he doing to you?
Got him on the leash, cause he's a wild animal. So we found this particular free camping site through the website freecampsites.net. It's part of a national forest here. But this particular site, because of its history, which I'm a little foggy on, is part civilian, part army, went through some... Anyway, now it's federal land, but it's a campsite like most other national forest campsites, except for instead of charging you a very small camping fee, they charge you none at all. And it's actually quite nice. You don't want to go swimming? Come on.
Maybe if it was like the temperature it wasn't in Florida.
But this campsite has one creek and another creek joining up to that creek. That's like a river though. Man, that's nice. 30 now?
I don't know.
Oh, it's totally 30 now. I'm not carrying anything. It's important, isn't it?
It's not very deep if you fall anyway.
Chippy, how did I get over here? You need to come over here? Yeah, you don't care. You don't care how cold it is.
Oh, that's deep. That's really deep, Simon. Now he's soaked, Simon.
That's okay. You'll dry off.
It's cold out, though. You have a stick on a string. Come here. Come on, buddy. Come here. Oh, yeah, that's a big stick. I don't think that's a good stick to bring with you. Good boy. Come back to who you really love. Me. Feels very Canadian today.
Yeah?
You know, like the air just feels Canadian. I think it's called cold.
I think you're getting loopy. There's a wild turkey, so Champ is running after it. It's not going to end well for you, buddy. That's not a fight you want to win. Or lose. This is not a fight you want to be in.
Okay, Jam. Come here.
Come here, buddy. Yeah, some wild turkey. I think there's two of them. They ran up the side of the hill. He's so far behind them. But he's going to jump after them anyway. Come on.
Come here, buddy.
Come here. You suck at hunting. Yeah, we'll give you some chicken. We got chicken.
Hallelujah.
Champ, the magnificent hunter, couldn't get us a turkey, so this is what he brought us home. A nice, juicy log. Yeah, that's good. That's some good hunting you did there, buddy. Fucking squirrely. Some of these trailers look like they stay here and no one's here for them. There's no other cars in this whole place, but there's a ton of trailers. Home sweet home, eh, Champ? Home sweet home.
Do you think you've gotten better at making fires?
Oh, I doubt it.
What?
I doubt it. As this one burns out. This thing is too much wind this time.
Promise.
Oh, I don't know. We get the chicken, a couple pieces of chicken out. One portion each, like a nice size one, you know?
Yeah.
I'm gonna put rice and veggies and a sauce with that, so I think it'll be a fair amount of food. Put my charcoal briquettes on there. Get a little air on that, a little bit more heat. We got some cooking material. I'll make some dinner. Shelby's making a little bit of a med leaf potatoes. Gonna get a sauce going.
Sauce boss?
Sauce boss.
Sauce boss is gonna do the sauce.
Potatoes and chicken and veggies.
Potatoes, chicken, veggies.
What else, Chef Shelby?
I don't even know what we have right now.
Yeah.
We have some pepper. I think that's all we have for veggies.
Now, I know that this is a really small place to live, but we still manage to lose stuff all the time. In the back of the cupboards, find all kinds of stuff we didn't know we had. So we're going to have to do a little exploration, find out what we're going to have for dinner.
Simon hasn't been having a very good time out there cooking his chicken. But while he's been doing that, I've been in here kind of setting up. Doesn't that look nice? I mean, a little campy, but, you know, it's kind of what you get. And then I'm also making some rice in here. Some rice we had left over that we hadn't used. Taco rice. We'll see how that it goes. It's been in the cupboard forever, so we thought we'd use it.
Cooking with hot coals. Got it heating up. Still kind of cooking slow, though. Let's see if I can get it hotter.
Good?
Good. Chicken.
Looks chicken-y. Potats.
Potats.
Potats. Gonna stay out there, champ, or are you gonna come in while we eat? That's what I thought. Alright, you ready to eat?
Ready to eat. Shelby's awesome chicken wrap sandwich dinner. Fire cooked by yours truly.
Did you want to watch Cora while we eat? Or do you want to like talk to each other?
Well, you set it up all pretty. I think we can talk to each other for a few. Then we can watch
just
Cora.
A few. What's the verdict?
10 out of 10. Would devour again. Our house looks gigantic from this angle.
Is it too big?
It's just so spacious.
Is it time to downsize?
I think it is. This is too big.
Yeah.
This is our little campfire for tonight. We're gonna have a little campfire, stay warm. And then we're gonna watch some TV shows that we're watching. Yeah. Curl up on the couch.
It's nice. It's like 7 o'clock and I don't want to go to bed. It's still light up.
Yeah.
It's really nice.
Light's nice. Summer is back.
Yeah. It's time for summer.